said, let's get out of this town, drive out of the city, away from the crowds. I thought heaven can't help me now, nothing lasts forever, but this is gonna take me down. He's so tall, handsome as hell, he's so bad, but he does it so well. I can see the end as it begins. My one condition is, say you'll remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, big red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. Wildest dreams.
And on it goes. This is Wildest Dreams by Taylor Swift. This version is based on a performance she gave at the Grammy Museum in 2016. The Grammy Museum is a museum celebrating pop music, popular music in its broadest sense, and it is in Los Angeles in California, USA. So do drop in next time you're in LA. So there are five chords in this song, which I will show you shortly. Two sections, verse and chorus. There are more verses and more choruses in the song. I didn't bother you with the second verse, which goes into details about him running his hands through my hair. I didn't really want to leave you with that picture in your mind. It's bad enough you remembering me standing in a nice dress, to be honest. So let's look at the verse. Three chords in the verse. The first one is a C. See, you possibly know already. If you don't, there it is there, okay? Finger one is on string two, fret one. Now do your very best to make sure it's only touching that string. It's quite easy to let it sort of lie down and on top of string one. You've got to make sure it's not touching string one at all, or indeed any other string. So there is string two, fret one. We've got finger two on string four, fret two, and finger three on string five, fret three. Now, this chord sounds best when you play it from string five downwards. If you hit string six, which is very easy to do when you're strumming away, it's not the best sound. It's not terrible, but it's not ideal. So try if you can to strum from string five. I'm using a pick, but you can just as easily use a thumb or use index finger, whatever you prefer. So C is our first chord. Our next chord is E minor. You get to play all six strings for E minor, two fingers involved, both on fret two. I've got finger two on string four, finger one next to it, tucked in really close on string five. So I've got C to E minor. And that's quite a nice chain because, as you might have noticed, finger two is in the same position for both chords, so it doesn't have to move. Finger three comes off, and finger one makes a diagonal move from where it is on string two across to string five. There you go. So C to E minor. And our third and final chord in the verse is a D. So D, triangular shaped chord, looks like that. And it's got finger two on string one, fret two, finger one on string three, fret two, and in the gap between them, it's finger three, and that is on string two, fret three. Now this chord should be played from string four downwards. Now, again, if you hit five strings, it's not too terrible because the low note A is part of the chord. I prefer to hear the lowest note in the chord as what's called the root note. In other words, the note D is the root note of the chord D. If you hit five strings, that's okay. If you hit six strings, not okay. So do your very best to avoid that, all right? Sometimes when people are strumming, they find it difficult, understandably, to pick out which strings you're playing. But if you just do D like that, really doesn't sound so good. So try your best, and it's about sort of leaning downwards towards the higher pitch strings. Just kind of tilt slightly down towards the strings nearest to the floor. So verse, we've got C for two beats, E minor for two beats, and D for four. Now, the pattern, the strumming pattern I'm doing is, it's very roughly two downstrokes on the first chord, two downstrokes on the second chord, E minor, and then this pattern when I play D. So it's going to down, 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 down. Now this is a pattern that I'm playing pretty much throughout the whole song. Now you don't have to copy that exactly. The most important thing when you're strumming is to keep the strumming hand moving. Even if you're not playing the strings, even for one, two, three, sometimes more passes by the strings, to keep that hand moving, and that gives you the rhythm of the song. Sometimes people can't help themselves, they want to play the rhythm and they do a jerk. That's not so good, a jerky movement like that. You keep it flowing, keep it up and down. Okay, so if you notice when I'm going my first two downstrokes, I'm going down, down. I'm going, actually my hand is going down, up, down, up, and it's only the first down that connects with the strings. What the advantage of that is, even if you're planning to just hit that down, if you happen to hit it again, it's really okay. You can vary the rhythm as much as you like. I'll give you some random examples here. Now, I'm not planning that, it's just, I could do it again several different times with different rhythms, and it's all good, all right? So what I'm saying really is it's not a strict thing, this song, and most songs, to be honest. The pattern that you strum can be your own. You can do your own variation, and that makes it a little bit interesting, a little bit of your own personal creation. Right, so that's our verse, C, E minor, D. So in the chorus, we've got a new chord, G. Now the version of the chord G, there are a couple of different variations. The version that Taylor Swift does in her Grammy Museum performance looks like that. It involves all four fingers, and it's got finger 2 on string 6, fret 3, finger 1 on string 5, fret 2, and then all the way down at the other side of the guitar, you've got these two fingers, 3 and 4, both on fret 3 and on string 2 and 1, like that. If you find that a little difficult, and possibly you're not used to using that pinky at all, because most of the work you do in the guitar does involve the other three fingers, if you can't really get that one organized, it's really fine to use just finger 3 on string 1. That's a perfectly decent G, so you can do that. Or this. The advantage of doing it this way is that we're going to change the chord D, which we've learned already. Notice that changing from that version, I've got my finger 3 in place already on string 2, fret 3. So the change is a little bit easier. These two fingers are going to travel all the way down like that. That's a good, chord change to practice, because in lots and lots of songs, you have to change from G to D or D to G. So that's well worth practicing. And you can do it just as I'm doing. You don't need to strum the whole time, just get used to that finger movement. And you'll soon develop what's called muscle memory. You'll be able to do it as I'm now doing it without looking at it, without even thinking very much about it. Your fingers kind of get used to just making that movement. So we've got G and then D. And then we've got our final chord, which is A minor. A minor looks like this, sounds like this. So what we've got is finger 1 on string 2 fret 1 again, finger 2 on string 4 fret 2 again. This time finger 3 is going to go in between them, tucked in next to finger 2, and it's on string 3 fret 2. The reason I'm saying again is because the chord that follows it is a C, which is the first chord that we did in the tune. And notice all you have to do to change from A minor to C is move one finger, and that's finger 3. And it comes out of its position, tucked in there, stretches down to string 5, fret 3. So the chorus has got those four chords, each of them for two beats each. And you do the whole sequence four times through. Last chord is a C, and then there's a bit of a few beats pause before the next verse would begin. And so there you go. Wildest Dreams. Great song. I hope you enjoy planning to play that one. All right, see y'all soon.